We are back. Another episode of New Pod Flow Podcast, episode 37.
37? Oh, shit. Damn.
Yeah, 37. Oh. Yeah.
Sounds.
This nigga had me thinking I'm wrong. What the fuck?
My bad. Nah. I forgot we did two last week.
Yeah. Yeah, episode 37. No guests this week. Y'all niggas just stuck with me and Vern.
Yep. What's up?
Don't ask me how I'm doing. So I can't remember this thing. His nigga name was Bam. It's an old nigga that used to rap from Louisville. That nigga said, all around the city, I got beef like 50. That's me right now. I got beef like 50. Everywhere, nigga. Work, home. I had me in the HR office yesterday.
God damn, nigga. Yeah, what you been doing? Stealing?
Nah. Beef, dog. People don't like me. Say I'm out, you know, I'm whatever. Got beef, man.
But you a manager, though, right?
Not necessarily a manager, no. But, like, I
got, but you got, like people under got, you, though,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, but.
So you're like a manager.
This is, like, different departments that's got beef with me, though. So I'm not going to go into detail because motherfuckers from the job be listening. So I can't even talk about it. That's all I was saying. I got beef everywhere.
Damn, man. Well.
Beef everywhere. For you, hope it does. I feel attacked, man. Attacked. Nigga, oh. Everywhere. I just thought about the other person I got beef with, man. We can't speak on no women's shit on the pod.
Nah, man, we love you. We love you. She know who we talking about.
Yeah, man. I love everybody that's got beef with me now that they listening.
This nigga stupid. But anywho.
Yeah, good gravy.
Fam, what is good gravy, nigga?
What? Nothing. I mean, shit.
I sent this nigga a picture of an ass. This nigga said good gravy.
God damn, dog. See what I'm saying? This nigga gonna make me sleep on the couch by the dumpster. The couch they just threw out.
Said before it's gonna be in the dumpster. shit. But nah, man. I think it was Tuesday, I seen it was trending on Twitter. I got on Twitter and I noticed that no Vaseline was trending. So I was like, what the fuck? So I clicked on it. And then come to find out, motherfuckers was talking about the greatest rap dishes of all time. And I guess it was like a consensus that no Vaseline was number one.
Okay.
I mean, no. Don't get me wrong. No Vaseline's dope.
It is, though.
But it's not my. It ain't my personal. He did do dirty on her too.
Yeah,
but it's not. It's not my personal favorite. What you think about no Vaseline, bro?
No Vaseline was. I mean, it was hard.
Plus, nigga, we was kids when that shit came out.
I mean, you know, you gotta go back. We had to do your due diligence to go back and listen to the shit.
I mean, I think the hardest diss ever is Back to Back. I'm bullshit.
I know you are, for sure. But, dog, when you say shit like the greatest diss of all time, it just puts a lot of weight on anything that you choose, dog. So, like, now it got me kind of backpedaling on what my pick was.
Well, I mean, that's what they said, the greatest diss. But, I mean, I'm going to talk about my favorite diss.
Favorite diss is something that's a lot more.
It's just all subjective, like it was like consensus that no Vaseline was like that. You know, that number one. What makes a good diss?
Like what? Like not make a good diss, but like how do you when you like listening to a diss or whatever? Like what are some of the elements that you're looking for?
I mean, it's just all about the disrespect.
How disrespectful they are.
Yeah. I mean that's what it's about. That's why I hate when people talk about Drake and shit. Like,
why do you hate when people talk about Drake? That's what I'm waiting for. Because
Back to Back is like the
nicest diss song.
Yeah. And then of course he had his shit with Pusha T, and Pusha T bodied him. Yeah. And then he said Pusha T was
went too far.
Like, yeah. Nah, nigga, you don't go too far.
Yeah,
like I was literally just because there's actually because like after I seen that on Twitter, I was at work. I pulled up on Spotify. I just typed in diss songs, mm-hmm. and people had already made playlists.
Yeah,
nigga, I was listening to that. I had the can. I was like, bro, why is? I was like, this shit's on Spotify.
Which
like
one?
It was bro, it was all kind of shit on Spotify that I was like, that's from mixtapes that I wasn't expecting to be on Spotify.
Niggas rapping on other people's beats.
So a nigga, they had Cam rapping over at that Stan beat. Yeah, talking to the Nas.
That's not about like Nas, dog. We talked about this already. That's about Stan Spit. That's why he chose the Stan beat. I don't even know who Stan Spit is.
But Cam was beefing with Nas too, right?
Yeah, he was definitely beefing with Nas.
Fam, when I was a kid, I thought that shit was about Nas.
I did too, dog, forever. I ain't gonna lie.
Yeah, this dude was like, I hang with you on Mother's Day because your mother's dead.
That's fucked up.
I thought that nigga was talking about Nas, bro.
Yeah, no, Stan Spit. Whoever.
Who the fuck is that?
I don't know.
Never heard of dude. But nah, definitely, when you talk about a diss song, it's gotta be disrespectful, dog. Like, you gotta talk about some shit. Like Jay-Z, when he did, I mean, Nas was disrespectful on Ether. So that's why Jay-Z had to come back with that, fuck.
Takeover?
Nah. Oh. Takeover was first.
Oh. Shit, I don't fucking remember.
God damn it. I'm trash. Yeah, I love Ho, and I forgot the name of the. Super Ugly. I'm glad you just said Super Trash.
Yeah.
Yeah, Hov came back with that Super Ugly.
Yeah.
And he ended it. He was like, what'd he say? Skeeted off in the Jeep. Left condoms in your baby seat. Nigga fucked his baby moms. That's disrespectful, bro. That's the type of shit. That's the type of energy I like to hear on a diss track, nigga.
What if it ain't true, though? What if they
it
say
is
this
true.
I know, but what I'm saying, what if they say super disrespectful shit that just ain't true? They still get.
That's part of it. I don't think Tupac fucked Faith Evan.
Okay. I think he did.
I don't know.
I really don't know. I don't know. I liked, like, I was listening to The Bitch and You by Common. What I liked was every single line was about Ice Cube. That nigga didn't waste one bar on anything else.
Shit, you talking about bitching you, let's get into it.
Okay, yeah, we can play.
With an attitude named Q, step to the con with a few. Now what the fuck I look like dissing a whole coast? You ain't made shit dope since America's most wanted to see from the Midwest to the East. On the dick of the East for your first release. Your lease is up at the crib house, niggas get evicted. And videos of white boys talking, you get wicked. Natural born killer, nigga, you natural born God. Read, rich, got the nerve to say you rob. Hypocrite, I'm filling out your death certificate. Slinging bean pies and St. Ives in the same sentence. Should have repented. On the 16th of October, guess the beast besides George Clinton. To rock over rap careers over better off acting. What trouble I see in managing WC and WAC 10. You're backed into a four-corner hustler. Lying on your dick. Said you was fucking her. Use higher learning. Don't take my words out of text. Went from gangster to Islam to the Dick of Das effects. It'll take the nation and millions to hold me back from giving you mouth shots or hit with the pipe your Ralph got. For sucker ain't around. It's your Friday. It was good. I wasn't salty. She was with the boys in the hood.
I see the bitch in you when you don't speak.
Not a line wasted. The nigga talked about that nigga from beginning to end. So, like, you know. Like I said piggy bank too. And on there, 50 was like, he was dissing niggas, yes. The song, like, he was dissing niggas through the whole song.
Yeah, that was multiple people.
But at some points he was just saying other stuff that didn't have anything to do, like bank shit, sell, buck shit, sell, game shit, sell. I'm rich as hell. Yeah, like, it ain't had nothing to do. But it was dope still, like the flow and everything was cold.
But he was dissing niggas like he's dissing they ain't them. Got money. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
but I hate that though. I do hate, like, yeah. that was Drake's approach.
Yeah,
even with Pusha T, I sell more albums than you.
Yeah,
like, I hate that. Yeah, that's trash. Hov did that shit with Nas a little bit, but Hov is so cold though. He can, you know what I'm saying?
And
he gave Nas. I mean, I don't know. He did body Nas on Takeover.
I feel like you just used whatever.
I think Mobb Deep got the worst of that shit, but
oh shit, nigga, Mobb Deep. I forgot about Blood on the Wall. By Joe Budden. That motherfucker's nasty.
He dissed my book.
Joe actually got a...
That nigga done dissed everybody, bro. Everybody. I can't keep up, though.
Yeah, he dissed everybody.
Then, but, like, I like... It's hard for me, bro, because I actually got a lot of, like, favorite diss songs, but...
Loves the beef.
And a lot of them is just, like, on, like, literally, like, you know what I'm saying? I came up on G-Unit, so I love G-Unit.
Yeah.
And literally, these niggas got... I wish I could have found a Hail Mary, nigga, where they was all going in on Ja Rule.
Nigga, niggas was dissing Ja Rule. I didn't even know disliked him. When I heard Busta come on, I was like, what?
Yeah. I wish I could have found that, dog, but I got I love Game. Game came out with a mixtape, dissing G-Unit, or 50 to pretty much the whole G unit the entire time. Stop snitching, stop lying. And that nigga did the 300 bars. That nigga dissed them niggas for 12 minutes.
Good grief, dog.
I mean, but you should know every word.
So no. Nigga, you wasn't rapping 10, 12 minutes.
Fam, I was, bro. Game's one of my favorite rappers.
Oh,
bro.
My God.
Nigga, I was like 14, bro. Nigga, that's all I did. Nigga was download mixtapes, nigga, and just listen to music all day.
But good grief, dog. To know every word to a 300 bar song is nuts.
Hey, I was dedicated, fam. That's how much I listened to it, though.
Unit. Wake the game.
I did, though. Nah, I didn't. Because I still fuck with Lloyd. Lloyd was on my, he was one of my favorite rappers, too. Yeah. But I did think 50 got weak. Like, after the massacre, I was just like, and people hated, I told you the other day, bro, people hated on the massacre. I liked the massacre.
The massacre is all right. I liked it.
But that nigga 50 wasn't playing when he came.
This with the kid must have ceased existing. Little nigga, now listen. Yeah. Your mammy, your pappy, that bitch you chasing, your little dirty ass kid. I'm fucking racing because success is not enough.
That's what I want to be. That's the type of energy I like there.
You get knocked, you get fucked in the yard. He's a pop tar, sweetheart, you're soft in the middle. I eat you for breakfast, a watch was a stain for your necklace. And your boss is a bitch, if he could, he would. Sell his soul for cheap, trade his life to be sure. You can buy cars, but can't buy respect in the hood. Maybe I'm so disrespectful, cause to me you're a mystery. I know niggas from your hood, you have no history. Never poke nothing, never pop nothing, nigga, stop fronting. Jay put you on, X made you hot. Now you run around like you some big shot. Pussy, it's easy to see when you...
My nigga Terrell gonna like it when you hear that tomorrow. You fuck with 50. But nah, it's I mean, the whole song is ignorant. And then he got the chick at the end, or it's not a chick, it's a dude talking like a chick.
Okay.
Talking about she can't wait to see her boo, Ja Rule.
Yeah.
Or his boo, I mean.
50 went extremely hard at Ja during those years. Even though New
Wayne's never video. Stopped. They everybody got the clip. Ashanti.
Oh, yeah. No, yeah. He was dissing everybody.
And nigga Lloyd Banks said, what the nigga say? He said, something Ashanti sideburns. He said, why is Ashanti sideburns sticking in mine? I was like, nigga. Because, like,
oh, my God.
Fam, them niggas went at every. Them niggas was bullies back then, bro.
Yeah.
Nigga, 03 to 07, them niggas was fucking bullies, dog. And then Game came. Really then Game stopped. Came and just started bullying them.
Yeah.
I mean, because I mean, I don't think, I mean, by the time Game was like dissing 50, I don't even think 50 cared about rap no more because he was just into a whole bunch of other business ventures and shit. But yeah, man. But yeah, that's one of my favorite diss tracks. You know, I can't play all of them for y'all, but that's one of my favorites. But I do kind of agree with the consensus that No Vaseline is a nasty.
Yeah.
It's a nasty. I ain't heard it in a minute.
I'm gonna have to refresh my memory on it. But
another thing, bro. I love when it comes to diss tracks. I love when niggas put them shits on albums because they live forever.
Yeah.
Like Takeover, it lives forever. Ether lives forever.
Yeah.
Back Down lives forever because this shit's on a. It's on the art. You know what I'm saying? It's on the full body of work.
Yeah.
That's dope to me. Like Back to Back, that shit came out. I mean, it's a different era of music now. But that shit came out just standalone by itself.
Right.
Like, I like when shit is, like, I like how Push ended his album with Infrared. Like, he's dissing Drake. Yeah. And it's,
I was going to say, that's another element of this is that I like. Like, either every line in the song is about whoever you talking about, whatever, or just, like, one quick shot. Like, Infrared was... I mean, it was just a couple bars. Like, it wasn't like the whole song was about Drake. I mean, nothing like it. So, I prefer that.
What was about Drake and Wayne?
The whole thing?
And Baby.
The whole thing?
Yeah, the whole song.
I don't remember. I just thought it was like just a few lines in there. I thought he was rapping about
it. Well, the beginning was
shit.
About Drake, and then he
changed it.
Started talking about Wayne, and then he said, now niggas want to kill
Exodus.
Baby.
Now, I don't know what the best diss is. Exodus is cold.
Exodus is better than Infrared.
Exodus... Shit, Exodus is better than a lot of shit, though.
Nah, Exodus is fire.
It's because it's a dope-ass song,
and that's another thing.
Too.
I like when niggas say niggas' names, too.
Push ain't never said their names. I think Story Don is the first time he said a name.
Well, he did say his name.
When? On what?
He said Wayne's name on Infrared. He said Baby's name on Infrared.
Did he?
He said, now it's okay to kill Baby. Niggas looked at me crazy like I really killed a baby.
Yeah, he did say Baby's name.
And he said Wayne's name. He says, salute to Ross because the message is pure. He see what I see when you see Wayne on tour.
That's flash not a it diss, out the fire. Though.
I know the multi-platinum rapper trapped and can't retire. Like, he was dissing Wayne.
Fuck, you made it sound like Ross was dissing Wayne. Ross nigga, wasn't dissing Wayne.
Nigga's pen's nice, dog.
Nah,
but Ross dissed Baby, though.
Yeah.
Rather you than me.
Yeah. Fuck. Jeez.
Hey, that nigga got a cold diss. You know him and T.I. went at it, like, years ago.
Ross and?
Like, right after Port of Miami, or maybe right after Triller.
Oh, yeah. You know, they was beefing for some reason. About everything that we forgetting. Because niggas is definitely going to say Gucci. When Gucci said, go dig your nigga up and ask him. Or whatever
he's talking about. Jesus, the dude that he killed. I missed that beat, bro. I just wasn't into Gucci like it. And I rolled hard with Jeezy.
Gucci definitely won that by a long shot.
Well, I mean, he killed when it was
killed
his
dude,
homie, bro.
Beat the body and then rapped about it. That's...
Yikes. And then they squashed it.
Nah.
They did squash it.
Who? Squash what?
Because Rick Ross dissed Jeezy about that shit.
Gucci and Jeezy didn't squash nothing.
Yes, they did. I mean, they're not like best friends.
Young Thug just made a song and said, I'll never do a song with Jeezy and I'm okay with that. Or some shit like that. Yes, because he's fucked with Gucci. Dog, they will never.
I could have sworn they squashed it. Because Ross, man, actually, Ross had a line about it, dog.
I gotta ask you, dog. If a nigga killed me, dog, you just gonna like down the line squash beef with the nigga, be cool with him?
Nah. But I'm saying they. I mean,
dog, if killed me. Yeah, sweep that nigga's baby, but I'm done.
Oh, shit. It was funny.
But no, I think that Gucci and Jeezy beef still going on to this day. It's just that they just grown now. Like, they not really talking about each other.
I thought they like squashing, but they're not like best friends or nothing. You know what I'm saying?
Nah, not at all. I watched, it's crazy that this beef stuff's this week, because a couple weeks ago, they posted a video of Shawty Lowe performing his T.I. diss in front of T.I. at some award show they had in Atlanta years ago. And niggas start fighting.
I forgot
and
about that.
Through.
And then nigga T.I. was beefing with Luda. Them niggas dissed each other on the same track. Luda got that nigga to fuck up out of it too.
That's some more G-Unit shit. Them niggas.
Ah, Young Buck.
That G-Unit shit.
But I mean, like, the story of it is like they literally just both got on that beat and started rapping about each other. Neither one had heard the other one.
You think so?
Yeah, that's how
because
it turned out.
Because it definitely sounded like, because
that's why they took T.I., like the album version. I don't think T.I. is on it. I think they replaced it. I think Game replaced T.I. Yeah, he replaced T.I.
Yeah.
But on the little mixtape version,
they both on it.
Like Buck said, he sent it to each of them, but just with the beat, and it came back, and them niggas was both rapping about each other.
Nigga,
that's dope when shit like that happened too.
I don't believe that though, man. I'm going to tell you why I don't believe it. Because Buck had the first verse. T.I. had the second verse, and all T.I. said was Ludacris' name. And then Ludacris had a third verse.
Man,
and Ludacris powerbomb, dude. What Ludacris did to T.I. on that song was ridiculous, man.
Fam, I miss the old era, man. I miss my younger days, bro. Niggas was like fire. That? Niggas was rapping, dissing each other, nigga.
We still getting dissed, man. Just
nah, these niggas is high now. Them niggas ain't dissing each other, man. Niggas just fucking popping pills together and shit.
Popping pills together. I mean, I don't know, man. You right, though. It was, we grew up in that was a hell of an era for diss music and shit like that, like the beefs and stuff.
It's just like the NBA, bro. Like how niggas, like how the old niggas complain about niggas is too friendly.
Yeah.
Like that's how rap is now, bro. Niggas is just too friendly, bro.
Yeah.
And it's all because of Drake.
Come on, dog. You can't say it's because of Drake. Drake done dissed a lot of people, man.
Bro, he tries to be friends with everybody,
but
though.
He done dissed a lot of them, too.
Ooh.
He done dissed, he dissed Push, he dissed Kanye, he dissed Common. He dissed Joe Budden. He dissed Diddy.
Dog. I had a Common shoot. That was hard.
Yeah. He's got a couple notches on the belt, dog.
He got some one-liners. He ain't really made no diss song, bro.
That's not diss songs, no. But I mean, that's my thing, dog, is if you making, for me, this is me personally, if you making a diss song, at no point should you be talking about anything but the person you talking about, in my opinion. That's a diss song. If you're not doing that and you're just taking a shot at somebody, sometimes the shot's powerful. To me, it's like, damn, like he just gave dude a bar for no reason and just went on about his song. You know what I'm saying? I think that's dope. That's just me though. And Jay-Z's the king of that shit. So
nah, yeah, Jay-Z done set a line about everybody.
Just a quick little and just get it over.
Jim Jones and that nigga's on Roc Nation now.
That's the worst.
Nigga
dissed
the whole Dipset, nigga.
Everybody's
that nigga dissed Jim Jones. That nigga dissed Dipset on a Beyonce song. That's that nigga. You get dissed on an R&B song. That's trash, bro.
And then get signed.
And it's a number one hit.
50 did that. 50 dissed. He dissed Jada, and they ended up working with him. He dissed Mobb Deep. He ended up signing Mobb Deep.
He dissed Mobb Deep.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure he did. Huh.
And beef. Well, shit, he did. Yeah, him and Nas 50, beef.
50,
him
and Nas 50 beef. Had beef with everybody.
Him and Nas beef, and then Nas signed to Def Jam when Hov was president. Like, Hov signed him to Def Jam.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Because I remember Fat Joe did an interview. That's the worst. He was mad about that shit.
That's, I think that part of it is the worst. If you, like, if you in a beef with somebody and it ends with you working for them, not working with them, you lost.
Yeah, that's what Fat Joe said. He was like, he won the battle, but he lost the war.
It's the truth, dog.
He's like, man, nah, man, it was a bad move.
Yeah, it's the truth. Like pride wise, I don't think I would be able to do something like that. Like, and they just, if somebody just like straight up like disrespected me and then offered me a job, offered me a check, I just have to like, no, pride wouldn't let me do it.
Yeah, nah. But Nas was kind of like, I guess he was just in a bad spot, I guess. I don't know. I don't know if he's, I mean, he just, you know, I don't know.
Dude's,
I don't know, bro.
Dude's rich as fuck now.
Yeah. But I'm saying like music, from the music aspect. Side, yeah.
Maybe he wasn't into all the investing and stuff that he's into.
The music now, like, wasn't popping like it. Cause like after Steelmatic.
It was pretty quiet. It was kind of quiet.
Yeah. I mean, after Steelmatic for me, like the album that I fucked with is. Cause I mean, that Streets Disciples album, the double disc joint.
Yeah.
That motherfucker was too long.
Yeah.
I don't think I've still heard that whole motherfucking album, bro.
No.
And it wasn't that good. Yeah. And I know you don't like Nas, so this nigga just saying no, and he ain't
never
heard
it. I like Steelmatic, and I like the one where he had the dress in, on the album cover where he's holding the dress.
Life is Good.
Life is Good. I like those two albums. And
I like the Nigger album. I'm gonna
get killed for Untitled.
You like the Nigger album?
Untitled.
Hero.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't know about the album.
That nigga rapped about shit. That nigga rapped about chicken from as a chicken, nigga. That was fire. That was fire, nigga. You don't know what I'm talking about?
No. I don't know nothing about this. He rapped about chicken as a chicken?
I mean, because the album's called Nigger. So it's like all themes.
I thought it was called Untitled.
It was called Nigger.
I know. That's what I call it. But you know he couldn't.
Yeah, he couldn't call it Nigger. They wouldn't put it on the shelves. But yeah, he was like, yeah, he was like, you know how he got the song where he's rapping like a gun? Like, he was rapping like some chicken, bro. Swear.
Yeah, I didn't know. That's some.
Lord, Lord, y'all. What I'm gonna do? Lord, Lord, y'all. Shit is all true. Fried chicken, fly vixen. Give me heart disease, but need you in my kitchen. You a bird, but you ain't a key. Got wings, but you can't fly away from me. Driving in your bucket seats all the way from Kentucky to fuck with me. Look what you done to me, was number one to me. After you shower, you in your gold medal flower. Then you rub your hot oil for about a half an hour. You in your hot tub, I'm looking at your salary.
That's a shame how good a nigga can rap about some stupid shit.
That nigga is cold, nigga. Hey. And then Busta came on at the end.
Busta was rapping about chicken too?
Yes, nigga.
I know them niggas in the studio tearing up some wings. I'd love to be in that motherfucking studio when they was recording. Imagine sitting in a studio session when some niggas was recording a song called Fried Chicken. Dog, I'm in there. What? Some wings, some flats? I'm in there with some flats and some hot sauce, nigga. Probably a brew. Oh, man. That's a classic.
All right. What we on now, man?
Oh. You want to just work your way up? You want to talk about the Thanos snap? Pull it up.
I'm going to save it up.
Okay, I was going to say, go ahead, pull it up. Okay. You want to talk about Breaking Bad trailer? What do you expect from Breaking Bad, the El Camino movie? What do you expect?
I expect Jesse to die.
To die?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's got to die.
Looking at the thing, dog, I'm trying to remember. I guess to my knowledge, if the way I remember it was Hank was on their trail, but died. He was about to catch. He had figured out that Walt and Jesse was cooking the shit up, and he figured it out, but died. So what I don't understand is Jesse gets kidnapped.
Hold he on, breaks you saying out. That like it's in the movie? That nigga been dead.
Right. What I'm saying though, in the trailer they showed a little wanted picture of Jesse.
Yeah.
That he's like he's wanted for whatever. But I'm trying to figure out like how's he even wanted though? When dude was like he was cooking shit up, they found out that it was Walt. Hank found out it was Walt and died. And Jesse, all he did was
they just had both of them. They thought it was Jesse.
Who did though?
I thought in the
Hank,
show
because I'm saying what I'm saying is Hank did, but Hank got murdered. It's been a minute, dog.
Yeah, nah, you know. Like, that's what's trash. It's like, they're coming out with this movie 9 years later, and a nigga ain't seen the season in 9 years, so I might have to go back and watch the whole season, bro. I might start tonight, nigga.
Start fucking, I'm telling you now, dog, start late. It's not because it's not, like, rewatchable. It is, but it's just, it's something about something you've seen before, for me at least anyway, something that I've seen before going back to it, like something like that, especially with that slow burn that it had, it's tough.
And I'm just going to watch season 6 or 7, whichever one,
remember that season when,
nigga, they had a spell where it was like 4 or 5, it might be 3 or 4, nigga, them, all of them all was fire, nigga.
The my favorite one was there was one season at the beginning of every episode they just show like ashes and the doll in the pool.
They did that for
shit.
Every season.
No, there was they did that.
They would always show something in the beginning that wrapped up in the end.
My favorite one was the one where they had the doll and the ashes and shit in the pool though.
Yeah, in the fucking plane. Like, it came from the airplane.
Yeah. Because at the beginning you're like, what the fuck is this,
bro? You was like that for everyone.
This one in particular, Steeg, is the one that I fucking like. God damn. Why is this nigga sir?
Fam, the one with the, I wouldn't like it for that one. The one where I had Joe reaction was with the fucking spider in the bottle. Remember that shit? Had the spider on the motorbike, I think. The dirt bike.
Please explain it while I'm just listening to you.
Go ahead, bro. Get your shit out.
No. Go ahead. What happened with the spider in the bottle thing? Because I really don't remember.
I think
remember
it was like somebody's nephew or something. He was in the desert and he had a...
Oh yeah,
and he dropped it.
Yeah,
I don't know if dude died or something. He might have got shot. I can't remember.
Yeah,
but he seen some shit.
That was one when the kids found that motherfucking hazmat mask and put it on. Remember that?
Yeah,
dog. That show. Now that we talking about it, I forgot about all this shit.
That show's so cold. Oh, bro. That's my favorite show of all time.
People talking about like the foreshadowing shit. Like while it was still going on, I remember people was like. Like certain shit, they would pause and be like, dog, look at this. This gotta mean something. Because Vince Gilligan, that motherfucker's a motherfucker, dog. He's cold. So it was one, they had a shootout in the desert, right? And somebody had died or whatever, and Walt's about to try to go hide the body. At the beginning of the fucking episode, he walks up to the car. And there's a bullet hole in the car. But when he walks up to it, his reflection, the bullet hole's right in the middle of his head. Yes, dog. Yeah. I was like, this motherfucker's cold. Yeah. It's just stupid. It didn't mean shit. Yeah. But at the time, you just didn't know what was going to happen next. Dog. It was so fucking dope, man. I hope Jesse get away in the movie, dog. Dude's rich as fuck. And
is he rich?
Yeah. He's, dog. He
you, like, you like when they do shit like this? I don't even like when, like, back to the music shit. I don't like when artists make a sequel to an album 10 years later, so I really don't care for this shit.
But the first thing that popped to mind is when you say it's Port of Miami 2, and I don't know what was 2 about Port of Miami 2.
Nothing.
It's just the name of another fucking album.
I watched the pull up, and that nigga was like, Joe was like, why'd you put that song with Wale number 1? He said, because Port of Miami, because he said that was Gunplay's favorite song, and he was like, Gunplay is Port of Miami. He's like, Gunplay.
No answer to the question.
He's like, Gunplay would play that song over and over, so I had to put it at the beginning of the album.
Hmm. Well, getting back to it, like, for like shows, I don't know. I'll have to say, like, Bad Boys 3, for example, not excited about it. Not excited about it.
Yeah, like
that.
Shit like that.
No. But something that had good storytelling from, you know what I'm saying? I can't think of another example of something that had.
But there's no series like that where, or like a series, a movie, anything where if they come back, Because I fuck with Rush Hour, bro. If they made a Rush Hour 4 right now, I would definitely be in there to go see that shit, bro.
Now, it's Beating a Dead Horse, though.
Or Friday.
It's the same. It's just like Bad Boys. It's the same story.
But it's just Friday, you got to see it, though. I don't care about Bad Boys.
Yeah, you have to. I mean, because your dedication to the franchise,
every
I guess
time,
you
every
have to
time,
see
bro,
it.
Every time they come out with a new Halloween, I'm in there.
Halloween is...
I love Michael Myers, Chucky, every time.
Like, Halloween is something that they kind of, like, even when they mess up on it, it's good.
I even like the corny Halloween stuff.
Well, you bust rhymes no way doing karate. You talking about that?
They cut dude's head off, dog. He still came back, man.
It was the wrong one. Man.
I know, but that's just crazy that they just they not
that nigga came back
do.
And then nigga got that motherfucking 4-piece combo, nigga, from that nigga Buster. Nigga did a roundhouse on that nigga and he didn't budge. You remember that one?
Yeah, I remember one with Buster, man.
Nigga LL was
on there. They Kelly Rowland was on Freddy vs. Jason. He smacked her ass up against a tree. She flew like 25 feet. He backed
that,
in.
Hey, that movie was garbage.
It was horrible. It was horrible. As far as but this is to me this is a little bit different as far as I'm turning a TV show into a movie this many years later. There's really no examples.
But I do like that the same dude's on it.
That, but what don't make sense is...
Like the same dude's doing it.
Yeah, but I thought you meant like the characters.
Nah, not the character, but the dude is like the nigga that did the original show is actually...
Yeah, he's
still... actually doing the movie.
What don't make sense to me is all the people that they say they're going to have in it. They talk about all these people that's returning and they all dead. So it's got... What's it just going to be a bunch of flashbacks?
Could be. I mean, I mean, watching Power, Angela's dead, but she was just in, like, the episode before last.
Oh.
Yeah, that nigga was seen as a ghost.
Oh, seen as a ghost?
Yeah.
I don't know. I ain't gonna lie, the Breaking Bad trailer, dog, I was mad as fuck when that nigga opened up that door and it was Badger standing there. I'm like, not these dumbass niggas. Not these dumbass niggas, dog. Why? Because,
hey,
dog,
you had dumb as fuck, dog.
Because if you remember, like, you remember Breaking Bad. Y'all remember Breaking Bad, dog. Jesse came a long fucking way toward the end of the season. He finally, like, matured and all that kind of shit or whatever. Like, Jesse was like... You would thought he outgrew them niggas badgering. What's the other dude's name? Scooter? Whatever the other dude's name is, dog. You would have thought that he outgrew him. Dude gets away, and that's the first place he goes in the trailer. I was like, fuck, man.
Nigga, where are you supposed to go, nigga?
Get high. Huh? Niggas got nigga, all kind of money in the trunk, dog. You could have went to...
Nigga, exactly. Nigga, I got to go chill for a second.
Nah, man.
Dude was dirty and shit.
Not with Badger.
This nigga Badger, dog. Niggas was idiots, man. This nigga woke up.
That nigga Jesse probably killed the niggas on there.
That nigga had heads all in his house, high as fuck off that nigga shit when that nigga woke up, dog. Remember that shit?
When his grandmother's house was like she had died, moved out, whatever, and like they was having parties, smoking up all the meth and shit.
Yeah.
Nigga woke up, everybody was in that motherfucker sleep.
Oh, yeah.
We need more pizzas. Niggas was trash, dog. They was trash.
Remember
man.
That shit.
That's a great fucking show, dog. Cannot wait to this movie, dog. Especially now that we're talking about
it. I just can't wait to watch the last season.
Watch the last season? It probably would be good to watch the last season. It come out October 11th. Brush up on that last season.
Yeah, I'm going to start tonight. Turn on one episode.
Skinny P. I think Skinny P opened the door and Badger was behind him in the trailer. I'm like, not these dumbass fools, dog. This nigga Jesse's smarter than this, man.
What's wrong, Steve?
I was about to laugh, but...
No.
I was looking at this topic. I'm like, the fuck we about to say about this topic?
About which one?
This gold digger.
What I was going to get at was... Can we punch out? Because I want to read this. All
right, bro. So, I was on Twitter, though. And some nigga tweeted relationship question. If you lost your spouse in a Thanos snap.
That's already funny as fuck.
But 5 years later, the Avengers bought them back. But you already remarried with 3 kids and spent the life insurance on a failed food truck. Do you get back with your old spouse or stay with your new Thanos snap family? So, man, I'm going to go first, man. I'm going to stay
Hold on. We got to... I just want to make sure that we got all the information out there. So on the Thanos snap, of course, everything like was fucked up for 5 years, right? And then when everybody came back, the people that came back had only been gone for like 2 seconds. That's how it felt, based on the quantum physics and all that shit. So people, like the people that was gone from the snap, to them, they was only gone for a few minutes, a few seconds, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so that makes it even more fucked up, because your girl's probably like, damn, I only been gone for a couple seconds. You got a whole fucking family.
But that's not physically possible, nigga, to have a whole family in 3 seconds.
It's not, right, no, right, so, right.
Man, yeah, they've been gone for a minute.
I mean, all the time travel shit.
Niggas been in space, bro. Y'all in light years, nigga. We been living on regular time.
5 years. This nigga getting busy. Nigga, you got a whole family in 5 years. I can't, never mind.
Shit.
A lot can't happen in 5 years, though.
Yeah, it can.
A lot can happen in 5 years. So go ahead, Steve. What would happen?
No, that's a dumbass question. I'm just going to stay with my family. What the fuck?
Damn. How you gonna explain this shit to your...
There's nothing to explain. Nigga, you been gone.
She been gone for 5 minutes.
But she been gone for five... In Earth? Nigga, she been gone for 5 years, nigga. I thought you was dead.
Yeah. Did think she was dead. Yeah, for sure. Damn. So that's it.
I mean, I'm going to stay with my family. Who the fuck I'm going to leave my family in?
You going to just uproot your home.
You said it, bro. When you got babies, just marry them.
Come on, dog. What the fuck? Come on, man. Steve, I'm sorry that you do shit like this on purpose, dog. They already got this fucking... Of all the fucking things to snip, don't even ask me what to snip no more either, nigga, by the way.
You said what?
Don't ask me what we need to snip from the podcast. Nigga, we posting the little minute clip. Hey, bro, what you want me to snip? This. All right, well, I'm going to do this anyway, nigga. I'm like,
nigga, you said
fuck?
Something.
And then the caption, all that shit was bait, dog. Now, they on my ass.
Bro, you said something from the guy who said the entitled shit was trash.
Oh.
Clip, that shit was trash, like...
That was something in there, dog. You picked, I didn't even listen to it. Was it? I don't even remember what it was. I was like, when I saw, I was like, oh, crap.
Oh, you said it was the date shit. Nikki was like, nigga, that's trash.
I can't say a word right now. Anyway.
But yeah, I mean, who's nobody's doing that, bro.
Nobody's
great. Like, leave their whole family, bro. Like, sorry. Nigga just gonna say sorry.
I've only been gone for 5 minutes. And you see the Spider-Man movie? The new one after that? Them niggas that came back was like, when they came back, what did they do? Like, they was like 23 years old and shit, still in high school? Because it was 5 years later. I don't know. I just can't make sense out of it. I'm not answering this question.
Hey, why not?
Nah, I mean, of course you stay with your family.
I thought that was a dumbass question, but it's funny though.
It's hilarious, dog. It's hilarious to think about, like, because the movie didn't cover it, but somebody probably was in that situation.
But what if shit's so bad though, you like, fuck it, I'ma leave and go back to my old chick.
Huh? What are you talking
about? Talking about the Thanos snap. Like, he was like, would you leave?
Oh, you talking about getting bailed out of some bad shit. Like,
yeah, like, fuck it. I'm out of here, man. I'm going back to my chick.
Whole family? You just leaving?
Fuck it. Niggas do it every day, B.
I'm glad you're back.
Fam, niggas leave their damn whole family for strippers.
Dog, they was coming back in the middle, doing whatever they was doing in the middle of... snap too. What if your girl come back and then you banging the shit out of your ass
That's crazy.
This nigga just said that's crazy. Come on, man. Look at you, dog.
I mean, I'm just thinking about it. That's crazy.
Oh, okay. Nah, man, you definitely stay with your post snap family. The pre-snap family, man. It's a wrap for them, man. Like
it ain't no family, though. He just said a girl. Like, girl, just your spouse.
Girl, family.
Yeah. It's a wrap for all of them.
Dog, if it's a family, though, nigga. Though. If it's a family, you got to figure something out, man. Because that child support going to knock you in your ass like you wouldn't believe. If you, your whole family come back after the snap and you done moved on with your life, fuck. Dog. somebody's got to lose. It's going to be sister wives or something. Shit. I'm going to have to be some polygamy. I don't know.
Imagine if that shit happened in real life, though.
The snap?
Yeah.
Like, I don't know. I don't know if I want to be in the snap or stay after the snap, to be honest. Like, a nigga like me be like, I'll turn to dust, man. I'm good.
I don't feel so good.
I'm good with the dust, man. I would. I'm up in the air, dog, for real. I might take the dust, man.
For what?
Just things ain't going my way right now.
Fam, you all right,
bro? They ain't going my way right now.
We're talking about ending it all, man. You straight, bro?
I mean, they came back in 5 minutes, dog. I just want to go to the quantum realm real quick, you know, take a little dirt nap.
Nigga, that shit was 5 years, bro. You keep saying 5 minutes, bro.
For the people in the damn thing.
I don't give a fuck. It's 5 years, nigga. When you get back, nigga, 5 years done passed, bro.
Yeah.
But you never gonna fucking get back.
For you. It wasn't 5 years for you, though.
You ever seen Interstellar?
You asked me this once not too long ago. No, I still haven't seen it.
That's what happened on there, though.
Same thing. Dude came back and his daughter was older than him.
His daughter was on a deathbed. She was about to die. She was 80-something.
Damn.
This nigga in his 40s still.
Damn.
Imagine how trash this
is. I need to look into time travel, dog. I'm going to solve a few of my problems for real. Just fast forward a few of these niggas to their deathbed real quick.
Hey, bro, I'm fucked up. I thought you was talking about your sons. I was like, what the fuck's wrong with you, nigga? But I said, them niggas is that bad?
No, they ain't. Nah.
This nigga looking forward to the 18th birthday.
Mm-mm. No, man. I like them at the age they at.
And our nigga Keon is... It's still funny to me, bro.
He's hilarious, man. He's, hey, dude is so bad, man. It's ridiculous. Like, it's something ain't right with dude, man. I'm going to have to put him in a full Nelson or something. I don't know what I'm going to do to him, dog. He's bad for real. Dude just like he, now all he do is scream and throw stuff. And he just scream with a straight face. Like, he thinks he's whistling. So he be like this. But he think it's a whistle. And I'm like, dog, what are you doing? And then just pick up some shit and throw it. I'm like, what is wrong with this dude, dog? He's a feral animal. Like, dude, for real, done went nuts, man.
But how old is he, bro?
He'll be 2 in November.
Bro, when do babies start talking?
When do babies start talking? Well, you got to remember, dude's also, he was 6 weeks early, too.
So, uh-huh.
I mean, he's talking a little bit. I mean, you say a little bit of stuff here.
Yeah, that nigga says shit.
Yeah.
I seen that.
Shit like that. Shit like that, you know.
That's what you're teaching him?
No. I'm not a great father, though. If he learned the shit, you know what I'm saying? Like, he said, oh shit, that's what he say. It's a phrase. He's got it from somewhere. So I'm telling him to stop saying it. And then I turn around, something happened. I'm like, oh shit, in front of him. And then he started, oh shit. Like, he starts saying it. I'm like, ah, man. Like, I can't even get mad. Like, now I'm trying to use I don't know, reverse psychology, Jedi mind tricks and shit on him. Like, at first I was on him. Stop saying that. Don't say it. Be quiet. Now when he said it, I just ignore him. Kyler be telling on him, Daddy, Keon's cussing. I'm like, just ignore him, man. Maybe he'll just stop. Like, because he knows he's doing something if you get on him. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So now, he be cussing and shit, and I'll just be like, just not paying him no attention to see if he'll just quit. Like, all right, maybe I'm not saying anything.
Don't ever bring a nigga around me. I'm like, say it again. Say it again, nigga. I'll be laughing, though. I like when babies be cussing. That shit's funny, bro.
It's funny, dog, but at the same time, it's like, you know it's not right, so you just like, fuck. Like, you try to laugh about it later or whatever. But.
Hey, that's how Mikey be with his son, dog. That shit's so funny, bro, because I be like, because, like, it gets on Mikey's nerves.
Yeah.
But that nigga's funny, bro. I'm sorry, bro.
Yeah.
That nigga be funny, dog. And yeah. Mikey be laughing at the nigga too, but,
it is, yeah,
but he be like, he be yelling at the nigga, but he be laughing on the inside.
It is.
He be like, bro, the nigga, he's like, bro, this shit's so funny, bro, but it be so annoying, dog, because yeah. I'm tired of telling this nigga the same thing over and over again.
Yeah, they be hilarious and the stuff they just pick, they pick up on anything that they shouldn't be picking up on. The fastest, like. I don't even.
Friend, that nigga
I can't tell the stories that, because I'd be sounding like a horrible father if you knew what I was my kids were saying.
Bro, you know that nigga ain't scared. Like Mikey told me that since niggas be on iPads and shit, like that nigga don't be scared of scary movies. Like they about to take that nigga to go see It.
What? How old is he?
5. Yeah, like he just turned 5.
Tyler be on all that. He ain't messing with nothing scary. Well, he thinks he likes scary stuff until he watch it. Then he jump hard as fuck.
Nigga Mikey was like, bro, shit's on YouTube now, bro. They just be watching that shit. Because, like, he was like, his son loved Chucky. Like, damn, nigga. I mean, my little brother was scared as fuck of Chucky. Like, nah, he ain't got a doll or nothing, but, like.
No, I'm saying, does he sleep in the bed with his parents?
Oh, yeah.
See? No.
I'm saying he starts in his bed and he runs in her and jumps in their bed.
Because he's scared of the movies. Kyle be on the same. Kyle can't even watch Stranger Things, though. As soon as a Demi Gorgon pop up, he be like that. And he jump hard as fuck. And then when it's time to go to bed, he don't want to go to sleep. Like, oh, can I lay down with you? Or can you lay down with me? You know, you think of Demi Gorgon about to creep through the closet, man. Open up his mouth. I'm like, nah, this ain't even scary, dog.
It ain't, dog. It's really not.
Man, he's scared to death of it.
Oh, man. You ain't never say nothing about your shit, man.
About what? Nigga, yeah. I answered the question.
Oh, okay. All right, man. Podcast over. We out of here,
Steeg likes me being in trouble and shit, dog. Shit is detrimental, dog.
I know, bro. What are you talking about?
Why did you fucking make that clip, man?
Bro, because what you mean? Like, nigga, I asked you. You said something in the entitled part.
I only listened to it, dog. I'm not gonna lie, I wasn't a fan of last week's podcast. You know how I usually listen to them like 15 times?
Yeah.
I've only listened to both of those last week once.
Oh, well, that's
so I didn't. When you asked me what the clip, I just was just saying shit because I said exactly what the covers were. If you Entitled was the name of one episode. We used Marvin Cease as the cover of the other episode. I was like, just clip that shit. Answer it. Let that nigga know he's live on the new Pod Flow podcast. Nigga ain't about to talk about nothing.
Yo.
Yo, what's good, bro?
Recording the pod, bro. You on the podcast, man. Say what up.
What's poppin', man?
What's going on, Nick?
What's poppin', Vern? How you doing, bro?
I'm good, brother. How are you?
Man, I can't complain, bro. I actually just getting here from, doing a little
thrifting,
actually.
What's
y'all on, man?
Pie, bro. About? Shit, pie, man. We talking about relationship goals.
Hey, Nick, let me ask. Man. Hey, ask Nick, man. Hey, Nick.
Yes, sir.
Nick, you watched the end game?
Y'all watch what?
The end game, man. Avengers. The last
nigga,
Avengers.
You probably ain't seen it, have you, bro?
Nah.
What?
Nah, yeah, man, that nigga ain't in that shit, bro.
Nah, man, I've been messing with Marvel, man. I just haven't gotten into the Avengers old saga or whatever.
That's all the Marvel game was, though.
You know what I mean? Luke Cage, season 1 type.
Oh, okay, the Netflix. Okay. All right.
Okay. Yeah.
So if your girl was caught in a snap, and she disappeared, you started a new family in 5 years, and she came back, what would you do?
Man, I can't really hear you, bro. What did you say, Steeg?
Ask him, Steeg.
Nah, so...
Steeg,
so
tell me. Hey, Steeg, man, turn my man Vern's mic up, man.
Nah, ain't nothing about the mic,
nah,
bro.
Nah, you're on speaker, bro.
You're on the phone, yeah.
Okay, cool.
Nah, but it's like, so in Avengers, bro, this nigga Thanos snapped and niggas disappeared and shit. For 5 years on Earth time, but they came back in 5 minutes, you know what I'm saying, in daytime. They went to another realm. And dude said on Twitter, he was like, when your chick came back and you already got a family, it's been 5 years, you got 3 kids, you done started a family. He's like, would you go back to your old chick?
Nah. Jesus, man. I don't know that I've been all this Marvel shit, man. Crazy, man. I need a little bit more, man, in-depth scenario, man. I have to be, man.
Now, you just have to see it, bro. That nigga don't really know what we're talking about.
Yeah, man, I have no idea, man, what y'all talking about. But if it was somebody who you was already with, you know what I'm saying, and y'all was about to get buried, some shit, something happened, some shit, man, I don't know, man. I feel like, man, I'm getting myself in the hole, man. I don't need to be
able to Hey, Nick, I do it every week, dog. I do it every week.
Hey, bro, I'm going to hit you back, fam. All
right, man. Hey, man, it's always good talking to y'all, man.
All right, bro. Yeah. That nigga's funny,
dog. You say he's digging a hole. Yes, I'm digging a hole, man. One of these Wednesdays, I might just not show up.
I'm about to call and check on this nigga.
I might just not show up when he's Wednesdays. Now you gonna check on me? I'm like, man, I gave my life to God.
We got nothing else. Ain't shit else happened.
Not really, no. Trump about to get impeached.
Nigga's not about to get impeached, man.
He ain't.
All right, man. Thank you all for tuning in to another episode of New Powerful Podcast. We're getting the fuck out of here because we ain't got shit else to talk about.
Alrighty.
And we're going to see y'all next week.
Bye. New Pop.